Greetings people from Bear's Blend, my name is Ronald and welcome back to another whiskey review. If you are wondering why is he wearing the same clothes? Well, I just recorded the Delmore 15-year-old review, that is why. But today we have something different. We have a world whiskey on my table. In particular, an American single malt. That's proper English. An American single malt from the Westland Distillery, located in the nice town of Seattle, Washington, on the west coast of the Americas. And it has been established in 2010, so it is not around for a long time. This one is quite expensive though, around 70 here in the Netherlands, so I think it will be cheaper in the Americas, but not sure. It has not got an age statement, but it has been non-chill filtered, natural colored, and it has 46% ABV. That is 92 proof for your Americans out there. And this is an excellent single malt whiskey. In order to be called a single malt, it has to be aged 3 years and a day, and has to be made with malted barley percentage, I don't really know, quite high. Bourbon is 51% grain. I think the malted barley percentage is higher with single malt whiskeys. I'm not sure. This is a good one though. I will try to keep it a little shorter than usual, but first let's take a quick look at the box, etc. First, it has not got a cork. It is a screw top, but it is such a good one. A nice, thick, heavy glass bottom. It's a nice label that they got. It is quality. They have a whole site where they have a lot of information. So if you want to know more about this awesome distillery, check them out. The core range consists of a sherry cask matured whiskey. This is the American oak version, and then they have a peated one. This one is kind of the flagship. A lot of people say this is the best one. They also have a single cask and something different. But the whole thing with Westland is, and the reason why it is so expensive, everything is done with care and slow and hand, and a lot of the ingredients are local, etc. But let's take a look at the box. Nice box, cardboard box, some plasty bits on here. It is quality, it's nice presentation. It has been damaged, nice presentation overall. Alright, Westland Distillery, American oak single malt. A flagship malt is the core expression of a distillery house style. Westland American oak is a reflection of where it is made and the collective intent of those who made it. When we founded Westland Distillery, we had a vision for an entirely new category of whiskies distilled from the rich, flavorful barley of Washington State and matured predominantly in new American oak casks in the steady, cool humidity of our seaside home. This whiskey is a testament to that vision. All of these choices and ingredients conspire to create an approachable, mature, and unique American single malt that can stand with the best whiskies in the world. And I agree to that. This is a non-age statement one, but it's difficult to find a better non-age statement whiskey at this price. Definitely. It's nice. It has a dark color. This is American oak. This is not sherry matured. And remember, they haven't been open for quite a long while. And I got this bottle in, I believe, 2016. So, did I? No, it was 2017 already. But this one has been introduced in 2016. So, yeah, max 6 years with that color. Those are quality casks, yes. All local, etc., etc. But they said seaside, so we should get some seaside notes. But let's test that. Test it! Okay, That's the thing with this bottle. I don't know what kind of seal they use, but you can hardly open it when it has been closed for a long, long while. This is one of the better screw tops that's on a bottle, by the way. This is thick glass. When I get a screw top like this, I am not disappointed. But this is a $70 bottle, so this better be good. But it is. It's so good. Nice. All right. Well, it has been non-age stated, so I don't exactly know how long to leave it in the glass for. Because the normal thing, a year in the glass for a year in the cask, blah, 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 doesn't really apply to non-age stated whiskies. I'm home. I am home. It's right on the nose. It's subtle. Not getting alcohol. I am getting Seaside, but I'm getting quality. Especially coming off the Dalmore, which is, well, cheaper, but older. Different, of course. But this is better quality than the Dalmore. That's a fact. This is a complex whiskey, and it's non-age stated. So all those snobs who say, I'm not buying old non-age stated whiskeys because those are less of a good quality, and this isn't even coming from Scotland. What am I supposed to do with this bottle, paying around £80 or £50 for this, going down the drain? No, this is amazing. If you can get your hands on this bottle, because this isn't really available, and this is not widely available. So if you see this and you have a little bit of a budget and you're not really sure what to get, get this. Honey, fruity, bourbon characteristics, vanilla, caramel, some spices, but I'm also getting some Seaside. The nose kind of reminds me of the Dalmore, to be honest. But it's deeper. And well, this is just another example. Longer maturation doesn't always mean better quality. Of course, older whiskies are not better whiskies, they are different. But the time a whiskey matures in the casks doesn't matter. It's the type of casks they mature in what matters. And that's why I reviewed this one coming off the Dalmore. You can really nose this, taste this, and say this is quality. This can go as a scotch. There was only that little bit of alcohol hint in the development, but it is working really nice with the spices. I'm getting banana. Definitely banana. Ripe banana. When I first opened this, I was getting more fresh banana. It was nice. Not harsh fresh, but pleasant fresh. Good fresh. But this is deeper. Deeper fresh. Deeper. More full. Now, some oakiness appears. Some caramel. Some light chocolate, but chocolate banana. Some spices. Finish, still going. Still going. Yeah, still going. Chocolate. Banana disappearing now. Now it's chocolate. Hazelnut. There was definitely this sea influence a little coastal influence. I'm not getting anything like a Voelen or Artbeg. Artbeggy, like a Voeleny. But it has coastal influence. Salted caramel. Full, rich, deep, good quality chocolate. The combination with the banana, with the vanilla. This is such a good one. If you get it, this has been sitting for about 9 months, 8 months at this level. And this whiskey really goes well with time. Really. It really goes well. And natural color. This is probably one of my favorite whiskeys. And it's not that expensive. 70 euros in my case for this type of quality. It was good when I first opened it and yeah, it was nice. But at this moment of time, with some time in the bottle, some oxidization taking place, it's a whole different animal. I'm not saying it's better, but it's different. This is more subtle now, like an old whiskey. And the first time when I tried it, it tasted more like an NAS. It has some young influence, but some old at the background. Of course, there can be old whiskey in here. That old. But it was still nice and complex. But this is a gem. This is going to be savored. There's fruitiness. Oh, the development and the finish. With that little bit of extra alcohol in there. The 46% does it justice. But I am not getting that alcoholic coolness or burniness on the palate or on the nose or in the finish. There is indeed some alcohol in the finish. But it works really good with the spiciness and the oakiness. It really brings that out. And oh, this is such a good one. Let's add a little bit of water, just a drop or two, just to see what happens. God damn it. Two drops. Caramel. Those really good quality toffee caramel. Oh, this is such a good one. Yeah, I am definitely getting more toffee and caramel on the nose with that little bit of water. It has become a little bit more fuller. The freshness on the nose has moved back a bit. Those bananas are really in the finish. Oh. It's still going. Westland, you really did a solid. Oh my god. I haven't tasted this whiskey in about 2 months. And I cannot remember it being this good the last time I tried it. So it really comes alive after a long time in the bottle. Some whiskeys go well with oxidization, some don't. This one definitely does. And a little bit of water. I think if you get this and you open it and you add a little bit of water, more than I did right now, like half teaspoon, 5-6 drops, you will, I think, get a taste of what I am tasting here, like the oxidized version of this bottle. But it really isn't really that different from the one I remember. It's just a little bit more full-bodied, but all the tastes, etc., and the nice development has always been there. It's definitely the same whiskey. Which one do I personally prefer? I prefer this one. But I am kind of missing that little bit of fresh at the start that it had when I first opened it. Yeah, definitely. So this bottle kind of tells a story. It grows up with the time you have it. You should definitely enjoy this bottle from start to finish. There is not a sweet spot, I believe, with this whiskey. It changes along the way. When you first open it, to the moment where I am now, to probably the finish. It tastes like a different whiskey, yet it is the same. In my opinion, you should not drink this within a week or two. This one should really be savored and just be experimented with. Hell, if you want to drink it all in 1 week, go ahead, buy another one. Why not? No, but you will definitely not be disappointed when you first open it, because it is really nice. But it has changed for the better. Some whiskeys for the worse, some for the better, this one for the better. Let's mark it. I can't give it anything else. This is an amazing, amazing whiskey. I would just wish they put an age statement on here, but I don't really matter. I don't care. 10 out of 10, definitely. Yep, it's a 10 out of 10. Oh, those chocolate notes at the end. It reminds me of something I had. Something chocolatey I had. I can't remember. But it is quality. You can taste the quality. If you had some whiskeys and you're not sure, am I tasting quality? Yes or no? Because a lot of people say, oh, this is quality, that is quality. And you want to experience quality for yourself, get a bottle of this. You will know what quality means. This will raise the bar up in quality of single malts around the world. The things they are saying on the box, on the bottle, on the website, true. Absolutely true. This has everything. Well, except for sherry influences. But a lot of people swear with sherry-influenced whiskies. I have a lot of sherry-influenced whiskey. I really like sherry-influenced whiskey. But from time to time, I also want something different. Then I will go for a bottle of this. I cannot give it anything less than a 10 out of 10. Even when this does not have an age statement. If you give this to people at the blind tasting and say, rate this, I will rate this as a 500 euro plus. Not a joke. This is one of the best I've had in the last month. And this isn't really my most expensive bottle. The most expensive bottle I have opened at this moment in time is Macallan Sienna, which is also non-age stated, 43%, non-chill filtered, colored, yeah. This is better. This is so much better than Macallan Sienna. Macallan Sienna isn't bad, but this is just amazing. Well, no, that's not a good word. I am taking that back. This is not better than Macallan Sienna. It is different. It is on the same level of quality that the Macallan Sienna is, but it is different. And that's a really big mistake people say. It's better than this. Older whiskies are better than younger whiskies. No, not the case. You can find it better. taste-wise. But it is a different experience. Younger whiskies are more spirit-driven. Older whiskies are more mellowed down. More complex. You can kind of compare whiskies to people, in my opinion. Kids are, well, active, busy, don't really have a lot of experience. Yeah. But when you get to the older whiskies, and I'm not meaning 60 years and up, but older, like in 15 plus, 18 plus, like, people also get a little bit more experience, more mellowed down, a little gentle, you know what I mean? There are always exceptions, of course, but yeah, you can kind of compare whiskies to people. But just a moment, by the way. Smooth. It is so good. I said, well, the Lagavulin 16-year-old that I have, with which has been oxidizing a lot, that's on the same level of wow that this is. This is excellent. This is truly excellent. I cannot give this anything less than a 10 out of 10. I have to finish it. I cannot leave it in the glass. Gingerbread. Christmas. Cake. Honeysuckle. This is something extraordinary. Westland American Oak better step up their game and produce a whole lot more. Because if people discover this... will I buy another? When this is empty? Probably. And I say that a lot. Well, I would probably get another bottle. But there has been only one other whiskey that I really considered buying another bottle of for later. And that is my 12-year-old Glenronach, bottled in 2013. So it's actually the 18-year-old, 12-year-old model. You know what I mean? The 12-year-old bottling that was bottled in 2013 and before are actually 18 or older. And I will definitely get one of those because price, it's like 30, 40. It's a steal. It's complex. It's just perfect. And, well, I know Westland will not screw up all of their, whiskies, etc. Because brands have been known to do that. Lower quality of the cask, etc., etc. But they won't do that in the next 5 years. Because they just started. But when this one is empty or close to empty, I would definitely buy another one. Maybe not for opening then, but for later. Because the quality that has been delivered in this whiskey is just beyond belief. So I will definitely put a note. And on that note says, these bottles are just amazing. And this is one of them. And some whiskeys are just nice. You finish the bottle, you move on. No, this one is definitely a stayer. This one will definitely stay in my bar. And yeah. But I will not buy a new bottle of this right now. Because I have faith in Westland that they just will keep producing and making quality for the next couple of years. So I will definitely buy one or two more. setting them aside because it's just quality. It's just good old damn quality. This, and for the price, it's not that expensive. What a pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for watching. One of the best I've had. One of my personal favorites. That is for sure. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for watching. If you're wondering, by the way, which one do I prefer, this one of the Dalmore? I don't even think you need to ask that question. But if you still ask that question, yeah, this one is better. And I don't mean different. No, this one is better than the Dalmore. This one is higher quality than the Dalmore. Okay? The Dalmore is different. But it's in the same bracket, you know? Because, well, that one has been bourbon matured. This one has been bourbon matured. And the sherry influence in the Dalmore isn't really that noticeable in comparison to a Macallan Sienna, for example. So, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. Leave it a like. Buy this now. It's good. Yes, it is. I thank you for watching, and I hope to catch you later. Goodbye.